Hi everyone, Raziel from Pecan here. I would like to show you how to quickly set up a connection between your data source in Pecan and how to import data into Pecan's platform. Now, this is a very important step towards building your own predictive model. Of course, we provide a very nice demo data set, which you can play around with when you start working with the platform. But eventually, when you want to have a model that meets your own requirements and your organization requirements, you definitely want to use your own data. So let me show you how it's done. I'm currently on the homepage and I'm going to click the connections tab and then I'm going to click new connection. Pecan provides a variety of connectors that you can use and the list is updated all the time. If you don't see your connector here, you can export your data manually and use the upload CSV file feature. And I also invite you to click the missing a connector link and let us know what is missing. For the purpose of this video, I set up upfront a PostgreSQL database, so I'm gonna use this one. So now I'm getting to the connection details form. I'm going to quickly give the connection a name and I'm going to fill up all the necessary details. And then lastly, I'm going to click test connection and I wanna make sure that everything that I put into the form is filled up correctly. And it says test connection successful, so I'm going to hit create. And then based on the credentials that I provided, the platform is going to show me the list of tables that I am allowed to see. Now, it's going to take a few more seconds. And here you go, I have access to four tables, campaigns, customers, transactions, and VIP customers. The first table that I want to import is campaigns. Now, I'm going to click fetch metadata because I want to see the schema of this table. It's going to take a few more seconds, and then it's going to show me the list of columns and the data type of each column. So it's going to finish up. Okay, got it. So now I can expand the table and I can see that I have four columns and I have the data types. And now in order to import the data, I'm going to click import. At this point, the platform asks me to select which columns I would like to import. And this is very good when you have a table with the columns that maybe some of them have personal data or proprietary data that you don't want to import into Pecan. This is where you can just exclude those columns and only bring into Pecan what you actually need for the model to be trained. In this case, I don't have a problem. I'm going to hit select all. And I know that the campaigns table here is not frequently updated. So I'm just going to hit save and import. And then every time that I re-import data from this table, the platform is going to bring the entire table all over again. I also have another table here that is called transactions. And I know the transaction table is filled up with new data quite frequently. So what I'm going to do with it, I am going to import it, but I don't want it to bring the entire data all over again every time. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just wait for it to fetch the schema. And then when I click the import data, I am going to select all the columns, but at the bottom, I'm going to select a reference column. And the reference column allows the platform to understand or to find out which of the rows in the table are new rows. And then every time that the platform identifies new rows, it will just bring those in instead of like bringing the entire table again. And this is very good for cost reduction and so on. So in this case, I know that new data is represented by the date column. So I'm going to select this one. And again, I'm going to click save and import. I'm going to approve it. And you can see that both tables are now in the process of being imported. Now, this may take some time because usually these tables are very big. In order to follow up with these tables and know what's going on, I can go to the history tab and you can see that both tables are in progress of being imported. Once the tables are completed, once the import process is completed, I can go ahead to the predictive flow. I can create a new predictive flow, and then it's going to be available for me from the editor.